Do you want to make a beautiful full centerpiece using a crystal stand? I'm going to show you how. Stay tuned. Hello everyone, I'm Ramon and this is Ramon at Home. On this channel, we talk about interior design, seasonal home decor, DIY projects, and shopping tips, all on a budget so you can create a space that tells your story. If you're new to this channel, please consider subscribing. And if you already subscribed, make sure you hit the notification bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. On today's video, I'm gonna show you how to create a beautiful centerpiece for your table using a crystal stand and a beautiful green pumpkin. If you wanna see how I create this, please stay tuned. Don't forget to like this video and share with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to Ramon at Home for future decorating ideas. Let's get started. All right, you guys, the materials we're gonna use for today's project are some floral foam, and just so you know, this is recycled floral foam that I've actually saved from other projects. I always save my floral foam because I know I can use it because we will not see the surface. We're gonna use this crystal pedestal, which is actually a pedestal for a punch bowl that I have, and I'm gonna use it as a flower container today. That's another tip I can give you. Just because it is a pedestal for a fruit bowl doesn't mean that you cannot use it for other purposes. We're gonna use various foliages in the fall colors, as well as some green foliages. We're gonna use a big pumpkin for a center, we're gonna use a big pumpkin for the focal point, as well as some sunflowers. And just know that these sunflowers are very short, so we're also gonna use some of these florist picks to extend the length of them. And we're gonna use some moss that I got from the dollar store. All right, let's get started. The very first thing we want to do is we want to go ahead and secure our foam into our container. And the way I do that is I place a little bit of foam on the bottom of the container just to make it flush. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to lay two more pieces of foam and push as far down as I can. Then with our trusty floral tape, you can find this floral tape at any floral supply stores or any of your craft stores. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and give this a little crisscross right here to secure the foam. It is a dry foam, and this tape is recommended as water safe, so it's recommended for floral foam that soaks water for fresh flowers. But in this case, we're just gonna go ahead and use it to hold our container, and it's really strong, so you don't have to worry about it falling apart once we put our items. All right, so the next thing I wanna do is I wanna go ahead and get some of this moss around the perimeter of it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and cover all of these mechanics with this moss, and that's just a little bit more visually appealing than if you leave that foam just uncovered. So we're gonna go ahead and cover this like this all the way around, and that's just, like I said, it's a lot more visually appealing than if we leave that foam without covering. All right, once we have our moss covered, and also I like the organic feel to it, what we're gonna do is we're gonna start with some fresh greens. In this case, they're silk, but they're green, so I wanna go ahead and green some of these right here to extend the shape of it. So just notice that what I'm doing here is I'm gonna give first the length of the arrangement and the height. That's gonna define how wide and how tall this arrangement will be. And then I'm gonna go ahead and do one here to the front, like that, and then one to the back. And I always like to mix this greenery with fall foliages. I think it just makes it a lot more visually appealing, and it gives it a lot more texture. Once we have our length and our height defined, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and add some of this fall greenery, and I really just want more of the green to show in this case, because our pumpkin is green, so it's gonna give us a lot more texture. So what I'm gonna do is I do my length first, like this, and I just wanna mix a little bit of this with it. So I did two down and one up. Then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use this very inexpensive greenery from the dollar store to fill in the gaps. And the way I do that is I just cut them all at once, and then I just start to insert this to cover. These real inexpensive greens are really good to cover greenery and foam because, well, it's so inexpensive. And like I said, I just want a touch of this fall foliage because I really want the green to show, because our pumpkin is green, so it's going to really show better than if it was all orange. The contrast is not as harsh. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and just work my way around this container. Don't forget to put some on the top. And I have various types of foliages. So what I wanna do is I wanna go ahead and just use as many to give this arrangement a lot more texture than if you just use one or two. That's another secret I can give you. If you use more greenery types, like in the fresh flower industry, the more greenery, we always say that a flower bouquet is just flowers until you add the greenery. It's just what gives it so much texture. Now also keep in mind that I always like to add one type of foliage at a time. The reason why I like to do that is because that way you can balance your bouquet around. All right, I'm gonna add some of these magnolia over here. Actually, I'm gonna put this one on the top. This is just two. And I'm gonna cut some of these magnolia. I'm gonna go ahead and insert some of this. I also like to, I think I might have mentioned this before, but I also like to add various types of foliages, some big, some small, some tall, some short. It's all about the texture, you guys. With this particular bouquet, it's all about the texture. All right, so now that we're almost done putting some greenery into our bouquet, now also keep in mind when you do greenery, you have to do some up, some low, some in between. You have to weave them in, so that way it gives you a lot more texture. Once we have, I have one more, so I'm gonna go ahead and add it over here in the back. Once we have our container completely greened, what we're going to do is we're gonna add our focal items, and in this case, I just want it to be very simple. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna grab one of these sunflowers, and these guys come with a little wire, so what I do is I just put it right here against the sunflower, and then I start spinning around really tight, really, really tight. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add one right here, just one sunflower, and then we'll do a second one right here. Really tight. And then we're gonna add it over here. And then this pumpkin is made out of styrofoam. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and poke it with one of these guys right here. And then I'm just gonna go ahead and insert it right here. Then with our moss that we have left over, what we're gonna do is we're gonna do clumps of it like this. And like this. Just a little clumps of moss make it look a lot more textured, like that. And voila, you have yourself a beautiful centerpiece for your table. All right, you guys, that's all I have for today, and I really hope you have enjoyed this little DIY project. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and do me a favor and share it with your friends. If you haven't subscribed to this channel, this is the right time to do it because we're now just getting started. Now I'm gonna turn it over to you. Leave me a comment in the comment section below and please let me know which project you've liked so far this season. Fall is coming and it is time to decorate for the beautiful autumn season. I'm gonna link up on the archive right here a playlist with all of our previous fall decorating projects so you can catch up. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and share with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe to Ramon at Home for future decorating ideas. Until next time, bye. Also, all the way down. And that's gonna give us not only the height, but a little bit of the width. And to define some more of the width, I'm going to go ahead and add some of this Himalayan grass. And I always like to insert all of this to the center of the bouquet, because you have to imagine that there's